madness and fall asleep in disorder. Command a funeral, giving out directions. Rico swagger tweets towards every connection. The Stellas, the new kids on the block. Hear ye telling the children that Jesus Christ rocks. He brings God's word 24/7. The coolest new speaker on this side of heaven.
Pass the key.
Y'all know what to do. Pull it on over. Listen, Pass the key is coming through.
Pass the key.
Y'all know what it is. He's on point with the word. Doing it big. God's big.
Pass the key.
And he be breaking it down. Come one, come all. Pass the key is around.
Pass the key.
Bring it around 24/7.
All right, it reminds me of a story that where a person was beaten and bruised and humiliated and was dragged up to Calvary and they crucified him. But he told the people, he said, don't worry about that because in 3 days I'm going to rise, and when I rise, I'm going to have all power. If anybody in here know the power of God, let's get ready to praise him. Is anybody in here over this session that know the power of God? Let me see you praise him. Anybody right here know the power of God? Let me see you praise him. Anybody right here, let me know if you praise him or not. Anybody over here, let me see your praise him. Is anybody right there? Let me see your praise him. Are you ready to praise him? Are you ready to praise him? Well, let's get ready to hear for what the Lord has to say. All right.
Holy Ghost is mine.
Come on and give God a radical praise in this place. I dare you to give God. You don't have to look back to Monday to know that he brought you through. You can look back this morning and say, thank you, Jesus, for waking me up this morning. See, the Bible says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Now, if God woke you up this morning, guess what? That means that you have breath in your body, and you need to give God some praise in this place right now. He brought you to the house. He got you here, and you need to praise him like you know that he's the Lord and Savior, that he is the King of Kings, that he is the Alpha and the Omega. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall remain in my mouth. I will not let the enemy get the praise from me. Give God a crazy praise right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Don't play about your praise. Don't play about your praise. Don't play about your praise. You need to tell your neighbor, I'm here to praise the name. Excuse me if I bump into you. Excuse me if I get a little bit crazy. But I'm here to worship the name of the Lord. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the first Youth and Young Adult Sunday of 2011.
I will bless the Lord. Yeah.
It's now, you know how you used to just call somebody on the phone and you say, hey, how you doing? Now they are able to call on the computer and now they see one another on the computer. And so the little camera is looking at me and I'm looking at it. And they saying on the back of the end of their life, your room sure is dirty. And look like you got something green on your teeth right there. Girl, what's that back there? Did your mama just walk by? It's technology. But we're living in a day now that where we want things instantly. We can send information. We can even work on the cell phone, on the beach, and send a document to our employer. Because we want the results quickly, that's the age that we're living in. But Jesus, somewhere, didn't get the tweet. Because sometimes Jesus don't answer you right away. Because you have to go through a process. Because if he was to answer you right away, we'll be messed up. Because we would not learn anything. Because we know that Jesus is going to answer us right away. And this brings us to the text where Jairus, he experienced that. He experienced that, you know, his beloved daughter became ill. So ill that the doctors could not help her. She was on the brink of death. Now, Jairus must have been a praying man, and he must have knew about Jesus because the Bible said he went seeking Jesus. So much so that he traveled over to Capernaum to try to find Jesus. And not only that he found Jesus, now he docked there because he knew Jesus was coming over on the other side. It's right there in that Bible. And when Jesus got there, the Bible says that he was preaching to a multitude crowd. And when he was preaching to the crowd, Jairus made his way over to Jesus and he bowed down to him. He bowed down to his feet and he said, Jesus, my daughter is lying ill. But if you could just come to the house. Wait a minute. We can be on the 1 yard line and got 99 yards to go and look like things is bleak. Don't think we're gonna get the touchdown. It's only 4 seconds left on the clock and everybody done ridden us off. But what they don't know who's on our team is Jesus. Jesus. They don't know we train underneath the Holy Ghost. They don't know that we train under the Holy Spirit. And every time we get the ball, it's a possibility we're going to get a what? 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 Wait a minute. I'm almost out of here. Ooh, when I was a kid, I used to hate this job. When I was on the farm, and grandmama would say, son, it's your time to go in there and churn the milk. I said, churn the milk. And we would put milk fresh from the cow into this thing called a churn. I would sit there and up and down, 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 up and down. But then something miraculous happened. The milk got thicker. And the substance began to rise to the top. And when it rose to the top, we skimmed it off, put it in a mold, put put it in the refrigerator, and there we had fresh butter. And I got to thinking, when I was a man, I said, you know, that's just my life. You know, when we get beat, when we get bruised, when we get battered, but if we have our eye on the Lord, and if we keep our eye on the Lord, we may get beat, we may get battered, we may get bruised, but if we a child of God, we will rise to the top. And not only that we rise to the top, we have a purpose in life. Because they tell me, when you take that butter and put it on a dry substance, maybe called bread, it adds flavor to it, and you will be able to eat it. Ain't nothing like fresh bread with smothered with some butter. Yeah, but if you know where that butter came from, it took a beating, it took a bruising, it took a battering, but it rose to the top. But God knows our purpose. And sometimes we have to go through some battering, some bruises, in order to get to the person that God wants us to be.